One slushie, please. In this video, we'll learn how to make a slushie from fruit juice. Are you ready? Then let's get science. Brain freeze, brain freeze, brain freeze, brain freeze. To make a fruit juice slushie, you'll need some fruit juice, a paper or plastic cup, and a spoon. Start by pouring your fruit juice into the cup. Add as much as you like. Maybe not that much. The juice will expand as it freezes, so don't use a glass as it could break. All you have to do is take your cup and place it in the freezer. How long you need to leave it in the freezer depends on the starting temperature of the juice, the temperature of your freezer, and how much juice you're turning into a slushie. I had my juice chilling in the fridge, so it started at 3 degrees Celsius. I added about 250 mils of juice to the cup and placed it in a freezer set to minus 18 degrees Celsius. It took 3 hours of waiting for the juice to turn into a slushie, but it might be longer or shorter for you. After leaving the juice alone for the first hour, I gave it a quick stir every 30 minutes. And after 3 hours, I had a delicious slushie. Now all you have to do is sit back and enjoy. But Simon, how is making a slushie a science video? I can answer that, but first we need to explain how water freezes. Above 0 degrees Celsius, water is a liquid, and each water molecule is free to move around all of the others. As we lower the temperature, the water molecules move around less and less, until eventually, at 0 degrees Celsius, the molecules slow down so much that they stay in the same place. This is called freezing, the point at which water changes from a liquid to a solid. The water molecules bond to each other in a regular pattern, forming an ice crystal that gets bigger as more molecules slow down and add to it. So how is fruit juice different to water? Fruit juice is mostly water, and as we cool it down, those water molecules will try to find each other to form ice crystals. But fruit juice also contains sugar dissolved in that water. These sugar molecules get in the way of the water molecules trying to form ice crystals. Because of this, we have to cool the juice down to an even lower temperature for ice crystals to form. After those first few ice crystals form, less water is left in the liquid state. It's now even harder for the remaining liquid water molecules to find each other. There's just too much sugar getting in the way. So we need an even lower temperature for more ice crystals to form. This means that even at temperatures well below 0 degrees Celsius, our fruit juice will contain a mixture of liquid and solid water, which we call a slushie. Stirring the slushie every 30 minutes also helped the water to form lots of small ice crystals by constantly breaking them up. If you didn't stir it, you'd find that you'd get much bigger ice crystals. All this talking has made me pretty thirsty. Time for another slushie. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.